Be a part of towing history when the Spirit Ride comes to your area. 250 cities will be visited through 2018.
The notion of move over is not a new concept.
Together, we can raise awareness.
Millions of motorists will see the ceremonies and casket as it tours America. To learn more about the Spirit Ride, visit atspiritride.com.
American Towman TV.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz for Tow Industry Week. On this edition, we see how a tricky bridge recovery was handled with care by the crews of I-44 Truck Center and Wrecker Service in Missouri.
It was a bridge nobody wanted to cross. Four different companies turned down this job, an 80,000-pound dump truck stuck on an antique bridge. Mark Robbins owns I-44 Truck Center and Wrecker Service in St. Clair, Missouri. Robbins also owns Powerbilt Wreckers. He explains the recovery process using two Powerbilts, a 60-ton wrecker and a 70-ton sliding rotator.
Call for service was an 80,000-pound dump truck. It was a five-axle dump truck that was stranded on a 3-ton bridge and broke through the bridge. There was two crane companies and a couple other wrecker companies, and they backed out of it that they couldn't do the job. Well, I knew I had the equipment to handle it. I knew I had big rotators to handle it, and I felt like we could do the job. So we put the stick boom wrecker on the creek side of the bridge that we had to go through the field and the creek to get to it. And on the other side of the bridge, we put the rotator on there. We backed up to the bridges on each end. We run the cable off the rotator, tied it into the end of the boom on the 60-ton wrecker. And we clotheslined the front end where it was broke down through the bridge. Once we clotheslined it, we got the front end up, and then we put cribbing underneath there, some 3x12s, and so we could plank the truck backwards. So we started pulling it back with the auxiliary winches on the 70-ton rotator. And whenever we did that, which was a long process because of the 40-foot drop, so we had to make sure everything was finessed and everything went good and slow. Then whenever we did that, as we were starting to pull it backwards, the rears of the truck went underneath the bridge. So it fell through. So then we had to re-rig, pick the back end of the dump truck up, and get it off the bridge up onto the solid ground. One challenge is the bridge was made in 1911. It was a 3-ton bridge. The structural was completely gone on it. And it was a 40-foot drop. I mean, it was a challenge. I mean, everything had to work exact. There was no room for no mistakes.